part-time hippie or the weekend hippie or the occasional hippie has not caused any trouble in the Lower East Side. The hardcore hippie who in effect is a parasite or a drifter or just a plain bum has caused trouble both to the hippie community and to the neighborhood in general. I have been told that the newspapers have reported that there's a great deal of ill feeling between Puerto Ricans and hippies. This is absolutely not true. There are tens of thousands of Puerto Ricans here. Very, very few of them ever have had any trouble with hippies. Perhaps there may be a lawless element, teenagers principally, who have attacked hippies. But Puerto Ricans who do that, or Negroes or whites who engage in criminal activity, do not represent the community from which they come.
You believe then these are isolated incidents of violence?
Later I learned that, you want to cut off here? Returned to the site before he was released. He was accompanied by two Puerto Rican teenagers, one of whom had a double-barreled shotgun in full view, and the other one had a bolt-action rifle in full view. The next day I checked with the local police precinct, and I learned that no arrests had been made. And in fact, except for one minor report, no detailed account of Puerto Rican teenagers being present in full view of the public with rifles had been made by any police officer present.
What do you think that is?
My own opinion is that Deputy Inspector Fink, who is in charge of this precinct and who was supposed to be in charge of community relations, actually is politically controlled. And he has been instructed, I think, that under no circumstances is there to be any strict enforcement of the penal law in this precinct. I don't think that the violence was an expression of racial sentiment. The hippies are not violent. And by and large, the residents, the longtime residents of this area, are peaceful, abiding people.
keep the name of Tobacco Road, 'cause it's home. The only life I ever known, yeah. And the Lord knows I love Tobacco Road.
How do you feel about all of the hippies that have moved into this neighborhood?
Well, sir, I think it is a disgrace as far as I'm concerned. These people that will not serve our country, and I feel that every citizen of the United States, when it comes to the call that to go to war, I believe that every man should go at it.
Is there a lot of resentment, hostility on the part of the Puerto Ricans, the Negroes who live in this neighborhood, to the invasion of these hippies?
No, sir, I won't say that. This, the problem they have, they are just having them among themselves. And I don't see that for any reason.
There aren't a lot of fights in the neighborhood then?
No, sir. As far as the fighting is concerned, there hasn't been no fighting around here. There's all the problems that they have, they're just having them among themselves. Nobody bothers them. And they do whatever they want. That's what Mayor Lindsay wants, anyways.
What about the traffic in drugs around here? Is there much of it?
Oh, yes, plenty of them. That's one thing. There's more traffic and drugs around this section on here than anything else. And they get it for free. They get it from any place that they want to get it. They just give them to them, and that's it. So everybody uses them around the old hippies.
You see them buying it and getting it?
I have seen this on various occasions. They have given them to kids. I have taken them away from kids, 12, 10 years old. They even show them to me. And I tell them not to take that. In fact, there was a day that I took a couple of pills that a kid had in his hand, and I gave them to the police over at the corner down on 7th Street. And they just took them and threw them out. I don't know what they've done with them.
The violence like that occurred here last weekend.
Well, it seems to me that what happened to that girl, considering that she came in from the good people, she came over to this neighborhood recently, and It seems to be she didn't want to mess around with any of the boys, and as far as a sexual relation is concerned, and having money in her possession and all that, I figured that that was the cause of the killer, the cause of rape.
Yeah,
well,
you want to change. You lit over there too? How do you feel about the hippies?
Good ones, you don't know who they are either. That's why you can't judge them all. But the thing is that since I was living here, I moved out because I figured it's no good for my kids and it's no good for myself either. Because, you know, I used to drive a cab, now I'm driving a truck. And I used to come home late. And with these people around, you know, I was jeopardizing my life every time. I used to come home every 4 o'clock, 3:30 in the morning. So I moved out. And as he said, you know, about these people not serving the country, that's the only thing that I hold against them, nothing else. They live their life and I live my life, that's it.
Do you think the hippies are violent people?
I wouldn't say that. You see, the thing is they're taking this, whatever they call it, LSD, you know, it makes them do things which they won't do if they were on the right senses. But it can happen to anybody. Like if a man don't drink and he gets drunk, you don't know how he's going to act. He can be, you know, the nicest fellow when he's drunk, and he could be a violent one. So, you know, it's hard to say which one is violent and which one is peaceful.
Do you think the hippies are
Have you ever had any trouble with them?
Not personally, I never had. Because I try to get away from it. As I said, you know, I was driving a cab and I quit driving a cab. I like to work days, which is better. I'm home with my wife and kids.
What do you think about the hippies that live down here?
I don't know. Really, I don't know. I used to live around here and then I moved because I don't like the neighborhood now.
You think that's because of the hippies?
No, not so far, but I don't live the neighborhood now because so much pressure around here about my kids. I got a wife and some other kids, you know, and I want to move around.
Do you sympathize with the hippie cause of living, as they say, as free men?
No, really, I don't like, really. I don't like. But I like freedom, but not in that way. I was born free and I want to be free, but not in that way.
You dirty old man. Too much. What about the moral character of the hippies, their activities?
Well, I respect him, or all of them, you know, I respect. And I expect most of them respect me, you know. I don't care about the people, just I care about my family and myself. And then I move from that people.
It's a silly question anyway. Go ahead, tell us about your friend Groovy.
Hello, you can sum it up in a very few words just to say that he was a beautiful cat, man, and he was real. Because there's a heck of a lot more than you could say about that. To know him for 5 minutes was a loving. I mean, anybody in the village would tell you that, anybody who knew him.
A lot of people say that this happened because of the resentment of a community to the hippies as a group. Do you find that?
In my own mind, I don't believe it.
Why?
Because I know that Groovy had a lot of friends down here. In like, you know, in all the places down here, you know? And in all the groups. And I couldn't see, like, if it was a discrimination thing, why they'd kill him, you know? It just doesn't fit, because Groovy... because, like, Groovy wasn't the type of person that anybody would want to kill.
You don't find there's an incompatibility between the people who have to live here and those of you who choose to?
What do you mean, an incompatibility?
How do you get along with the people who've been here a while?
I don't know. I got a lot of friends down here. Groovy had a lot of friends down here. I mean, like, friends are where you find them. You know, like, to have a friend, you got to be a friend, right? And that's what Groovy was. He was everybody's friend.
How much of a part does the LSD turn-on scene have to do with violence of this nature?
I don't think it has anything to do with it. Absolutely nothing.
And it said he was lured into that building because of it.
Not acid.
What was it?
There had to be speed. What else?
I'd compromise my virtue for some. I would have gone down there if somebody said there was a lot of speed down there. So would he.
Does a speed thrill produce violence then?
Sometimes. Depends on the people who take it.
You get violent?
No, but I get hostile. Speeding. No, I don't get hostile.
Yeah, I do.
Have you ever bit anybody when I was on speed? Which reminds me, where's my dog? Anybody see my dog? Oh, okay, then she's all right.
You don't think there's any difficulty at all, then, generally speaking, between the hippies and the Negro and Puerto Rican community of the neighborhood?
I don't know.
What do you think?
No, I don't think so. I don't think so, because they seem to get along pretty well, you know. All of them commune together, this, that, and the other. It's a pretty good scene, you know. It's nice.
There are not a lot of fights?
No, I haven't seen any, not since I've been here. You know, I come around here every once in a while. I haven't seen any since I've been here.
You find a lot of your friends moving out of the neighborhood after all this?
I don't know. I'm going to convince them to stay because, like, I don't know. It just seems like they're running away and they got nothing to run away from. Because I don't think this has anything, the murder had anything to do with the people in the community. I think it was more of a personal thing.
Oh, a sadistic thing.
Yeah, right. One of the two.
Could have been sadness behind the drugs.
I didn't hear you. Say that again.
Could have been sadism behind the drug itself. It could have motivated
it. It's just pretty much the direct opposite of what your friend Groovy was looking for in the way of peace, quiet, love, and all that.
Speed means love.
I'll tell you, if nobody else ever finds it, Groovy had it.
And that's what Groovy did.
Because, like, wherever Groovy was, man, I mean, even if you were down, it's like when, the minute you came in contact with him, you were up, you know? He was just like that, man. No matter how down you were, he could always bring you up.
The thinker. Speak.
I don't know. I don't want to go into that now, though.
Do you think that the thing can be basically blamed on the use of the drugs?
No. I think it goes a little bit further than that, probably. I don't want to go into that either, but it can't be blamed just on that.
No, I think he was an alcoholic anyhow. I don't think he was...
Do you think being turned on can result in violence like this? Well, I mean, it does it induce violence then?
No.
Euphoria,
man. That's the furthest thing from violence in the world. No, that's a very general term. When I say turned on, I mean, like, say a guy is working, right, you know? And he's doing his thing every day, 9 to 5, and he's busting his back, you know, and he's going home and putting his money on the table. And all of a sudden he says, well, you know, how come? What for? And then you get this kid, like all these old, wise, and sterile bastards sit up on the draft board, you know, and they get all this prime young ass and send it off over to Asia to get killed. You know, but how come they never want to go, you know, and they die in these antiseptic coffins, waving flags and eating apple pie and shit. And kids see that, they, you know, like, wow, what's, you know, the hell with that shit? I don't want anything to do with that nonsense. And the kid breaks out on the street. But getting doped up, that doesn't induce violence. Like, smackheads and speedheads, you know, like, these guys that take methadrine and heroin, like, the junk becomes a fixation with them, and it's their whole life, you know? And they'll knock you off in a minute to get a fix. But dudes that, you know, smoke weed and drop acid, that's just for joy.
You think the violence of this type is going to push the hippies out of urban communities like this?
No.
Well, in California, they are.
No, because it's going to bring everybody closer, you know, on a closer level of understanding, knowing where each other are at and everything, and as more of a protection for each other rather than being a loner or self-centered and have to walk alone and everything. At least if you know where everybody's at, then if you see someone walking down the street, you know whether to look out for him or whether he's one of you or whether you just ignore him or what. Everybody become much closer since then. Like, it's really been upset because, like, this thing really got me going because, like, Groovy and I were very close, you know, and it's just like a bad dream. Like, you know, the other night, you know, and when I woke up, I said, well, you know, like, maybe come downstairs here and Groovy will be on the street because maybe he's been up in somebody's path for a couple of days crashing, you know. Because sometimes he was like that, you know, you didn't see him around for a couple of days. He's been asleep for a couple of days, you know. It's just a lot of people feel that way, you know. Wow, maybe it can't be true. It can't be true because he's someplace sleeping. Maybe he'll come back down here and he's here. That's how Groovy was with everybody. You just can't believe it because anybody else, it wouldn't have been nothing, you know, maybe because people weren't that close to nobody but Groovy, like, and he's really missed.
Thank you much.
In California,
we're out.
That's it.
ABC.
What do you think's behind violence like this?
I don't know. Everybody's so hostile against each other, maybe.
Everybody's what?
Hostile. Against each other. Nobody likes each other. Like, the hippies don't like Puerto Ricans. Puerto Ricans don't like blacks.
Is there a lot of hostility, resentment?
Yeah, plenty of it.
How does it manifest itself? How does it, how is it demonstrated?
Well,
you mean it's all happened before?
Yeah.
What kind of thing?
I don't know. Two people got stabbed at 11th Street. Everybody's been getting cut up, robbed. You know, two people died right in front of Galahad's door, was stabbed to death about a couple of months ago.
There's nothing new. Why did you come here?
Because I really had no place else to go right then, because I had run out of money, and I was sort of, well, I've been hitchhiking to Newport, Rhode Island with my girlfriend for the folk festival, and she just took off, and like I didn't have any money, and like I couldn't hitchhike back across the country by myself, so. We started originally from Detroit, so I just haven't made it back, and it's all right here now. At first I didn't like it because I was sort of had to be here. It's the only place I knew where I could live.
What about you? Have you had any problems like this?
No.
How much of a factor do you think that the drug thing is?
What do I think about it?
No, how much of a factor do you think it is in inducing violence?
I don't know. I don't think so. I don't think it induces violence. You know? I really don't.
You think it's just the basic hostility?
Yeah, well, I mean, everybody that gets killed now, they use LSD as a cop-out. They say, you know, they took LSD and that's why they killed his mother and everybody else, you know.
Okay, very good. Thank you.
Resentment or anything? I don't feel so.
You haven't had any problems like that?
Yeah, I mean, everybody's had problems. Everybody's had problems, but I mean, you have problems any place you go, you just have to live with them, you know, and just have to, in your own mind, think them out, you know, put them down or you know, just say the hell with it or whatever you want, you know, just, that's life.
Supposed to change, you know, like these people see something that they hadn't seen before and it's upsetting to them because they're not, you know, completely aware of what's going on, and it's as if, you know, somebody was into something that they weren't into, you know, and then when all these, like, I work with the youth board, you know, and like, when all these kids, these Puerto Ricans and guys we had over in Brooklyn, stopped gangbusting and shooting junk, you know, they just completely washed away. And then, like, the people, like the kid brothers, you know, that couldn't go gang fighting and stuff, they got turned on, you know, and they said, well, that's all bullshit anyhow. And they came and they all, you know, dug their, and they went and did their thing here. And those old people got upset because they couldn't really, you know, understand what was happening.
How could you describe the undercurrent that exists in a community like the East Village and the apparent increase in violence?
Well, it's a strange thing that's happening in a slum area like the Lower East Side, otherwise known as the East Village. You have a what you would call an elected poverty group, those who have been elected to poverty by birth, such as the Negroes and Puerto Ricans and other similar groups, and they have been conditioned to tend towards middle-class life, that is, to work themselves out of the ghetto, and for the TV set and the chicken in every pot and the car and all that possession syndrome. And in comes the hippie, who is a middle-class dropout, who has given up all that possession. And there is a friction caused, because it's like an insult to the poverty groups that exist down here. They don't understand the things that the hippies want, and they tend to get upset by them. And also, the hippie brings with them a type of lifestyle which is strange to the common poverty groups down here, and they tend to reject the hippie all the ways around. And it causes for friction. And the hippie is trying to show that he is not concerned with the 9-to-5 bit. He's concerned with learning about himself and the world around him, and trying to spiritually grace himself with a better life and a better environment. And of course, it's paradoxical that he should come to a poverty group or a poverty area like the Lower East Side. But for him to come here means that it's the best area to get away from the type of life that the middle class has already laid out for him. Here the pace is slower, here there is more objectivity to look upon the rest of of society, which tends towards a speed type of motive, to a quick way of getting the dollar bill. And this causes a friction among the existing poverty groups down here.
Only a couple of these incidents seem to have drawn any significant public attention. Are they obscure cases, or is it a fairly common occurrence? Do you see any possible resolution to all of this?
Well, I hope there can be attained a understanding between the hippies and the rest of the groups around them, that the hippie wants to live in peace, that he's not trying to take away anything from the already poverty groups down here. He doesn't want the type of situation that the Puerto Ricans or Negroes want. And if they can make them understand this, it will tend to make the situation much better.
A week or so ago, they had a funeral out in the Haight-Ashbury section of San Francisco, declaring that the hippie, as viewed by the modern mass media, is dead for now. Do you find that same tone here in the East?
Well, what the San Francisco people try to do, the hippies in San Francisco try to do, is that they try to demonstrate the fact that the hippie was created by the media. And so they are going to kill him in the media and create free men. At least they'll rule their own lives. They won't fall into a pattern that the media has constructed for them. This was the idea that the San Francisco hippies had in mind. Whether it has worked or not, only time will tell. It probably hasn't, because the media has a strong pull on people's consciousness.
Some of the earliest hippies from the West Coast have elected now in the past year or so to carve out a brand new location for their way of life in the desert areas of Nevada and New Mexico. Do you think this may be the coming thing, that the hippies will move out of town and away from these ghetto problems, or away from this violence, and set up their own communities in areas now that are desolate?
Well, it's interesting that the spiritual path of any person seeking God has always been laid out thousands of years before this. You have to come back to the city. You have to go through the city in order to come back into harmony with your surroundings. And it's a sad but true thing that you cannot seek God.
So do you think that the hippie will be, in a sense, moving away from the city into these desolate areas? What kind of effect has the most recent violence had on this particular community? Is there a mass defection now of some of the younger people getting out?
I don't see any mass defection yet. I think that everybody is rolling it over in their minds of what they want to do next. And I think that they may have come to the conclusion that they should seek their life elsewhere, and that eventually I hope the hippies as a community and as people will go away from the cities and build their own areas where they could live together in peace and harmony.
What effect, what relationship does LSD have to this violence? I know there's implications that it's involved.
Okay.
Also, what about I'd like to ask on camera about your opinion of Gallagher.
I'd rather not give my opinion. No.
I thought you felt strongly about it.
Yeah, but I'd rather take care of that in my own way.
Well, are there any...
I don't have to send the message for the media to him. I can send the message personally. And I'd rather handle it that way. I mean, this is a personal thing. You know? I don't want to bring it out on TV.
Are there any such things, really, as hippie leaders, or is this a practical idea to have a leader of a community?
Well, the belief of the hippies is that every man is his own leader, that every man must individually seek his own destiny and his own way. It avoids the pitfall of a dictator possibly ruling over other people's spirits and minds. And people like the hippies do their own thing. Each one seeks their own level of talent and a way of life.
What effect does LSD and the other drugs that are used have on this violence? Is this an integral part of the violent spiral?
No. LSD is not a weapon. It's a tool. And I believe honestly that it has nothing to do with what happened down here. I think that the natural combination of LSD, of drugs, sex, and racism that the news and other papers have made of this situation couldn't have been better ready-made for them. It's something like a National Enquirer thing. It sells papers, but it has nothing to do and has no relationship to why this man was killed or why the girl was killed.
You speak from personal experience about LSD?
Yes, I speak from personal experience about LSD.
You don't find LSD as a producer of violence?
No, on the contrary. I find it a very... it's an individual thing. Each hippie is an individual person who must realize that in order to be attuned with his environment and his fellow man, he has to be away from the area which is not conducive to this sort of life. But in order for him to learn this, he must go through the city area, as Buddha did and as Christ did. He must come down from his ivory tower into the city to learn the emotional phase of who he is and what he really stands for, and to come out of that dark pit back into an area which will afford him a way of life which is in tune with God, nature, and all of mankind. And it's a sad thing that some people have to die in order to learn this, physically die, so that others may live. But it's the way of life, that the spiritual path that has been carved out for these people thousands of years ago by better spiritual men than these are.
Do you see the hippie movement going out of the cities and setting up more of these colonies in desolate areas?
Oh, definitely, yes. A year ago, a little over a year ago, the Underground Press had a meeting, a conference in San Francisco, which we discussed specific questions about the hippie communities, especially on the West Coast and the East Coast, New York and San Francisco, how that we should warn our readers that they should stay away from the cities, and that we are trying to set up areas in which they could live away from urban life, and how to support themselves and how to survive in the wilderness. We felt the need almost a year ago that it was important for the hippie communities to be away from city areas because of its violence, and it was just wasn't right for the people, our people, to live in such an area. And so the move had been made. There are places in Arizona and other desert areas away from urban life which have already been set up, and the next step is to be able to move out numbers of hippies into a country and desert area away from the city. And of course this recent violence only speeds up the issue and shows how important that this plan be put into operation almost immediately.
An awful lot of the people identified, anyway, with the hippie movement as such seem to be young people passing through a phase for a year or two, and then they kind of return to the normal way of things. Do you encourage this? Do you think it's worthwhile for kids, let's say, to spend a year or two in this kind of life before picking up with the rest of what...
I see it as a very important step in any individual's life to seek who he is. It's a sad thing that in this society, more than any other society that I know, does not have a phase for children or young people, young adolescents, to seek the way, to seek their spiritual selves. Immediately, they are thrown into college and thrown into work and into marriage with no possibilities of ever finding out who they are. Cultures such as the Apaches and other cultures, when a child becomes of age, like 13 or 14, the parents or the community turns to him and says, "All right, pack your gear. You're going into the desert for a year and get your vision. And come back, when you got your vision, come back and the community will take you in." There's no such a thing like that in this society of ours. It's a very complicated, rushed society. So the hippies, in a large way, provide that spiritual ground where a man can test himself. And it's very important for an individual to have that.
Okay.